What's going on, everyone? I'm pretty sure you guys are all hyped after seeing that awesome Bleach trailer that we've waited for all these years, and we're gonna do a lovely breakdown today. Because with me, I have, just like in previous videos, I have Roye. Give yourself a shout out, Roye.
Hey, everyone. I hope our discussion will be insightful.
Hopefully, man. That's why we're here. So let's talk about first, before I get Roye's thoughts into pre-animation and the director as a whole and his thoughts in general about the trailer, I want to add a few things about my opinion about it in general. I love that we got a confirmation, pretty much with Soifan, about there being essentially no censorship when it comes to, I guess, character designs. And obviously, this is important in some aspects. You know, it just gives us a little taste. A little teaser, which is very important because if you watched the Jump Festival live stream, or if you didn't, you know, it was specified that this was in fact a teaser trailer, so it's not anything to be like a trailer later on in the future. It is just a teaser to get you guys ready and a little bit hyped to get you guys talking as promo should, marketing reasons, as well as the no censorship as well. I do also want to say that, again, this is pre-animated. And would you like to just quickly discuss what pre-animation means for people that don't know?
I think the most important aspect to think about when we say pre-animated is that these shots that you see in the trailer are not stuff that is cut out from the episodes they've made so far. It's more so animation they made specifically for the trailer.
And that's why it flows in pretty well with the music and pretty much like has such a good synchronization with that as well.
Yeah, and you can tell that, of course, this stuff isn't from the episodes because it's so spread out from all over the manga that they would be so far ahead that it probably wouldn't make sense for it to have to air in October if that was the case.
And also that Ichigo and Bankai at the end, to which if you've read the manga, during that situation where Ichigo's on top of a building and he's fighting those hollows, he doesn't actually ever go Bankai. So that's also a great indication as well. But, I mean, whether you guys agree or not, you know, I don't really classify the middle bit as that important. What I consider is important is the start scene and the last scene, because I think that's really where the fluidity, where the color palette really shine about what you're expecting to get from the series. And we'll talk about the middle bit again soon after, but it really just gives a nice little kind of sense of what you are going to expect throughout the series, especially in those high Sakuga moments.
It's kind of like we said earlier, it's pre-animated, but that doesn't necessarily mean anything negative or positive. The word just pre-animated in certain circles have taken on some negative stigma because it's not like directly from the episodes, but it's not a negative by default.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so it's basically just a TV advert, essentially, of what you, you know, of something to give to the fans and promotional use specifically for Jump Festa. And I think that's what Viz also put into their title as well, that this is a Jump Festa teaser trailer. So, you know, this was specific for Jump Festa. And we've seen this before in the past, kind of like Black Clover also did like a Jump Festa thing, and also Toriko. Even though those contexts might be a little bit different, of course, it just gives you an idea that, you know, just because you see it firsthand looking like that doesn't mean it's going to look like that in the future. So now that we've kind of like addressed that it's not going to look like that entirely, it's a nice little, you know, little thing for you to expect. Because I also see a lot of people also talk about the purple Getsuga, which is actually more positive than negative in what I've seen from people's comments about it. And, you know, if I was to tell you it's canon, you know, would you believe me? I don't know. But it is, in fact, a little bit canon. And I'll kind of address that very quickly because it kind of deviates away from the PV. But this could either be an Easter egg, because there was a purple Getsuga in one of the album covers for Bleach's OSTs that Masashi Kudo also did, which could be a nice little callback. And people calling it the Galaxy or the Cosmos Getsuga is pretty cool too for a name. You know, if you merge the blue Getsuga and the red Getsuga together, you get purple, and that's why the Grand Ray Getsuga Tensho is also purple. You can kind of put those correlations together with the Fullbring. Whether I agree that the Fullbring version has a purple Getsuga is like, it could be what it could be. You know, like, again, I can't complain because it's technically could be canon. It could work, seeing as it's a Hollow and Quincy, you know, Ryatsu merged together. I mean, it's plausible. I know it's not what we're used to, but again, take it with a grain of salt. We'll see what it will look like in the final product, but it could just be a really cool aesthetic choice, seeing as, you know, maybe the blue or maybe even the red wouldn't fit with the color palette that, you know, the director was going for this trailer. So again, take it with a pinch of salt, and we'll discuss about that if it becomes more cemented later on in the future. So in terms of the director and the color palette and the shading, I mean, besides me absolutely loving it, I was skeptical at first because obviously it's a big jump from the original anime and seeing that color palette and then going straight into like this really dark, gritty undertone of Bleach, essentially. Like, I'm really interested to see what it's going to look like in like a daylight setting and see what the color palette's going to look like then. I think looking back at it many times that the color palette and the shading is like phenomenal. What are your thoughts about that and the director?
I think that from the trailer, we can definitely gain some kind of insight into what kind of ambitions they have for the color work and the backgrounds, especially, and how they intend to merge it all together to a visual style. And from the trailer, I can say that personally, I liked it a lot. Obviously, it will look somewhat different in the final product, but it gives us a pretty good indication of what their ambitions are.
Yeah, I was reading a really interesting, or watching a really interesting documentary on the director, talking about usually how backgrounds are usually like the second or the third process within the pre-planning or even in the production. And the director is known for actually making backgrounds one of his foremost, most important things when it comes to pre-planning, so he can work around the backgrounds. And for me, I mean, it may be a stretch, I don't know, maybe I'm saying something quite slanderous, but the backgrounds, like, they were beautiful, and they reminded me so much of like Ufotable backgrounds when it comes to absolute lighting and detail. So that was one of the first things that really like shocked me, was how beautiful these backgrounds were.
And it is, like you mentioned, in his previous work, Akudama Drive, it had somewhat of a special like production pipeline, in the case that they kind of moved the design process even earlier on in the core planning of the project. So maybe the director has had some great experiences from that and has chosen to do the same with Bleach. And in Bleach's case, which isn't an original like Akudama Drive, they have stuff to work from already. There's the manga and the previous anime that they can kind of make their own spin on.
Would you say that this is the director's first big work? Because besides Akudama Drive, which again wasn't really, I felt personally, appreciated until after its run, do you think that this being, I mean he worked on Persona 2, right? So, but I don't think many people know that. Do you think that this worries you at all, that this is like one of his first big productions, especially if it's long running too?
I'm not really worried, because he's definitely a very talented director. And I think he worked on the latest Digimon movie, for example. He was the director and did the storyboard for that. That was a pretty big movie, and he did a great job on that as well. And he does have quite a lot of other experience in his career.
Now, I want to talk about a little bit about a worry. I don't know how far this worry will go, because I'm a little bit of a fanboy with Kubo. The director did make a comment on Twitter saying the series composition in the anime version Bleach, Thousand Year Blood War, I will be the director, under complete supervision of Professor Kubo. All the staff are trying to make it the best work of October 2022. Stay tuned. Now, we knew this from the fairly early on through Kubo's Club Kubo and his comments in regards to that. Discussing with other people, it seems that the only, I guess, bottleneck in this production would be Kubo's perfectionism, if that makes sense, and potential, because obviously we know how much he adores his work and how he wants it to be how he envisions it. Do you think, you know, because I'm biased, so I don't think I can give a correct answer, do you think Kubo's supervision will ultimately be a potential downfall within the Bleach series?
I don't necessarily think it will be much of an issue. I'm hoping, although I don't know, that they have a good relationship, one where the mangaka, Kubo in this case, doesn't exert too much of his influence on the anime. We know from his previous experience with anime that he got more involved, but he let them do kind of their own thing as well.
Yeah, because he was doing manga, wasn't he? So it's not like he could have been in complete control.
Yeah, but in this case, of course, as he just said, it's a bit different because he's not doing a weekly serialization right now, as far as we know.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't think, since he's not a animator or a director himself, I'd assume that, as in most cases, he'd leave it to the professional when it professionals when it comes to the anime.
Yeah, well, given probably some like secondhand opinions, which we've already experienced through Bleach Brave Souls, and especially like some concept designs that he's done for them and the supervision, which I've seen from the Bleach Brave Souls art book that recently came out, seeing the many different concept arts and seeing what the official art was later on, and seeing Kubo's notes. So, and they usually have turned out pretty well, with exception for my personal opinion, the Quincy outfit for Ichigo in the game. But other than that, everything else is pretty good. Good for the majority of the parts, so I do have quite a bit of confidence in it. And I think, you know, as far as production time goes, I mean, we got this coming in October, which is essentially in 10 months time, just over 10 months time. Do you think, considering the first time we heard about this, considering the first time we did our video talking about the production, what do you think about the length of time now that we've got?
I think the time frame we've gotten is a very good thing. As we know, there's been this pandemic going on for a long time, and the anime industry in itself has suffered a lot from having to work in these conditions. And also the animator shortage and all the other problems in the industry has put a lot of strain on it. So I'm glad that they're not trying to rush it out as soon as possible, and that they're taking their time. And that hopefully by the end of the year, they'll be in a better position to make a good, long-lasting product.
Do you think with the time that they have, as of now, is a good production time to have? It's like, say nothing's been worked on, pre-planning's done, let's just say that. If they were to start animating now from previous series that you've known, do you think 10 months is enough?
Yeah, for sure. So I don't think they will necessarily have started much work on the key animation of the episodes already, even. I think that's probably gonna happen soon. It might have happened already. But usually it could be just, say, 6 months before they start working on it. I know with Attack on Titan, the final season, I believe around July is when they started working on around episode, well, say like towards the end of the first arc, I'd say. So give or take, I think 10 months is more than enough time from the stage I assume they're at right now.
Sure, and that's considering like 10 months is like the bare minimum that we've got at the moment. And considering it's going to be a long series, I assume it's going to be a long running series. I feel like obviously production isn't going to be stopping anytime soon, even past October. So, you know, as long as they've given themselves enough leg room and enough like breathing space between like corrections and errors and time gaps, that there's enough time, which I assume there's going to be. Because I've heard, you know, war stories before in the past. So, you know, I want to get your thoughts on the line filter, if there is one. Because I noticed, you know, with One Piece going in from, you know, Whole Cake Island, you know, and then going into Wano, their line filtering was really what put One Piece out there in terms of aesthetic. And I noticed in a few close-up shots, especially with Ichigo, that there's some really nice thick lines, some thick shadows, and some thin lines as well. And it's quite apparent to me that there is a filter on there and it looks gorgeous. Do you think there is one?
I think there's definitely a line filter of sorts. It's not as pronounced as the one that's currently being used by Toei in One Piece. However, what really stands out to me in the artwork for the anime is the highlights that's often next to the line work. So that's a part of the lighting design as well. You can tell that, especially in the beginning and also at the end shots. It's mostly pronounced in the beginning. You can even see it on Ichigo's foot when he first steps in. The kind of light lines that are next to the outlines of the artwork. I really think that it makes the art pop more and makes the lines more pronounced.
Yeah, the lighting I felt was, at first I wasn't digging it, but over time, like as I rewatched it, like the more I just became accustomed to it. And again, that's because, you know, you're going from two different art styles which are completely different from each other on a big scale. So, you know, it was fantastic. And I believe as well the resolution that this was made in was actually way higher than 1080p, because there was a 4K version out there somewhere, and it looked even more impressive, to say the least. So it wouldn't surprise me if it was made in high resolution. So that's why it looks as crisp as it does. Again, that's just my opinion. That's not a fact. I do want to talk about as well, just quickly, that don't worry essentially about the middle portions, like Rukia, Renji, Shinji, Komamura, Yoruichi. I did see a few people nitpick a little bit, saying like it doesn't look as good. And I think what those characters were, I think obviously there was padding in the trailer. That's why there was a bit of a long intro before getting into Ichigo. And there was a bunch of characters in between the first and last sequence because there was a lot of padding. And I think that was to showcase Shiro Sagatsu's new remix of number one, which I thought was a perfect choice to go with, you know, because again, nostalgia. But to get back on point, I think all those stills, if you want to call them that, because there was motion, obviously, I think that was just each animator being given a key role or a key like visual to really show off their style and what they can do. And again, there wasn't really one I really complained about the most. It was just like each animator having their time to shine for like that split second. And I was very pleased with it. You saw obviously some shots without backgrounds. You saw shots with some backgrounds, and it was, again, we've already been through this, it was very clear it was pre-animated, just to showcase those talents, especially. So will we see Kenpachi that detailed moving on a consistent basis? Probably not. But if they're focusing on those key moments in the manga, especially those big single page spreads or those double page spreads, and really highlight that detail and that moment, then I'm completely fine with it. As long as they keep a consistent model, then I'm more than happy, which I do believe we'll probably get for the majority. But those Sakuga moments are the ones to pay attention for the most, because that is probably the style, the key visual style that you are going to mainly get through the majority of the series. And of course, another thing to back up the pre-animated sense as well is because if you look, as you see on screen, there'll also be these images which are literally one-for-one animator manga comparisons, where literally each line from the manga is in the anime as well. So like you'll see Shinji, for example, each line almost identical by the pixel of where they're placed. So that just goes to tell me that, you know, they've done a quick trace, they've done a quick coloring, and done some movement in the mouth. And you know, that's expected from a pre-animated trailer. So again, so as long as the animators are competent with their coloring and their movements, that's all that matters to me. And keeping on model is what matters to me as well. So again, hopefully we can see more of a trailer later on in the future. I'm saying maybe Anime Japan, but you never know. I think we'll get a few trailers before it drops.
I think the trailer itself gives me a very positive impression of the direction they're going for with the anime. I'm excited to see what they can pull off with the colors and the lighting and the backgrounds, and how they can find a way to blend the two in a way that really makes Bleach feel like it has this kind of a new shine to it. Of course, not take anything away from the Bleach we know and love, but also just kind of get a new fresh taste of it.
Yeah, completely agree. Other than that, again, for a director to direct this promo with the transitions that he used, with the symbolism, I know it's a bit of a boring symbolism, but to show the logo of the new Bleach logo and then have that garnished in red to symbolize the Blood War arc, and then also, when you see the Thousand Year Blood War arc come underneath that and seeing blood dripping from some of the kanji too, that you wouldn't have really seen in the Viz one, but to see it in the kanji was like a really nice touch. So you could tell, and I don't know if you agree with this, but you can tell from this promo, and this is probably the most important factor for me as a fan, is that you can tell the passion within the promo. And as long as the team, which originally in the original anime, you know, I think Musashi Kudo also said that, you know, it was a passion project for them and they loved doing it. You know, this wasn't just a job for them. Essentially, I felt the passion in this trailer. So that means that we've got a happy team that's happy to do this series and are enjoying it.
Yeah, and I think that this might be probably Pierrot's biggest projects, or rather one of the biggest, if I were to be kind. The amount of anticipation for this, the amount of nostalgia, not just for us, but also for the people that are now working on it, is massive. And I've seen animators and other people in this industry in Japan get super excited to see Bleach come back. And just knowing that all these companies see this potential in Bleach just really gives me the impression that Piero is going to give their absolute A game with this anime.
And I think even Viz took initiative and bought as many rights as they could. I think they even bought the complete rights to Bleach as well, which I'll also have on screen as well through their statement. So that they're very hopeful on the project too, as well as Aniplex and the promotion that they've done for the expo and the thousands that they've spent on advertising in Shibuya, etc., etc. So no whole bars has been going on with this, with the marketing especially. And I think, you know, for Piero as a whole, I think, you know, even though they have big hitters like Boruto and Black Clover and X, Y, and Z, I think for a large scale, I think Piero feel, or they should know, that they kind of need Bleach to do well, because Piero needs to put itself back on a map of what it used to be, a great studio. And I feel like this is that time for them to say, look, this is what we can do, get more investors in, get more people hitting them up to animate their works instead of rushing to other studios, essentially, especially if you've got like big hitters like Netflix that are looking for good studios. So I think, you know, they want to make this a demonstration of what they can do. That's just from my opinion, of course. And I think even if you're an animator as well, going off common sense, if you're an animator and you want to be known and you want to have a good portfolio to work on other series in the future, having Bleach on your portfolio will be a big thing. So I think everyone involved wants to make this the best possible product that they can. Well, I hope you enjoyed this little breakdown. I hope you enjoyed and hopefully answered any questions you guys have had. Shout outs to Oe for coming through again and helping us have a little bit of knowledge towards the industry as well. Thank you, man.
No problem.
And with that being said, I'm going to catch you motherfuckers later. You guys, of course, have this fun. I've been Hansen. As always, people, peace out.